Hey guys, what's up? I wanted to make a quick video. Yesterday, Immersed dropped their open beta for the Vision Pro. So let's go ahead, we'll hop in the headset. This is the first time we've got 5 monitors in the Vision Pro. It's really cool. It is under beta, so there may be some crashes. There's a couple issues that I'll walk you through, show you things that I've had go wrong with it and that they'll definitely fix in the end product, but it's really cool. And let's hop into the headset to check it out. And look at that. I've got 3 monitors running on my MacBook Pro and fairly responsive too. I can look down here and I don't know if you can see the Mac screen. I know it kind of sometimes crops in the actual screen recording, but it's almost 1-to-1. I have to say that's really close to what I'm seeing in the Vision Pro down here versus up there. So not a lot of delay. That's nice. I know split screen had a lot of lag for me anyway. I would move the mouse, it would jump all over the place. It wasn't as good. I'm gonna go ahead and move this down here. We've got our menu here. You can connect your agent. You've got your rooms, which is coming soon, public. We have our monitor controls. That I've noticed isn't accessible, but I do believe it says, yes, please see Immersed Desktop Agent to do anything with the monitor right now. So that, I know in the Quest, I believe you can muck around with it in the actual headset, but this is a beta. It's not a, you know, fully functioning product yet. So let's go ahead. We'll go into the settings here. I will show you the display. So I've got 2 displays configured or enabled right now, rather, and I've got a 3rd display active. I don't exactly know how this works because I know that if I go down here and I enable a 3rd display, I get a warning that says, you do this, it's gonna affect the Mac performance. I can say yes, and let's go ahead and see if it crashes on me. I have noticed that occasionally, oh, there it is. There's my other display over here. So, I mean, come on, that's sweet, right? I'm sitting here, I've got 4 monitors around me. This is really cool. And you can move between them. Oh, that's right. When you do that, when you add a 4th monitor, it puts it as your main monitor, I've noticed. So like you'll notice at the bottom here, I've got my toolbar icons here. So let's go ahead and we'll open this up. I believe I have to move this over, which I've got to find my mouse because it thinks it's at the bottom of the screen. So we'll grab this, we'll throw this over here. And I think that will give me the ability. Yep, look at that. So I can just move through all the windows seamlessly. And seems like it's coming, like it's fairly accurate with where it's tracking the mouse from one monitor to the next. I'm not noticing that it's jumping too much. That's fairly accurate. We'll check this one over here real quick. Oh, that one, okay. That one is having a little bit of an issue, but if you'll notice, this is a lot bigger than this one over here. I think the resolution of that monitor, which one is that? That is going to be Immersed 3. Also, you'll notice it's smaller. So let's go over here to Immersed 3, and we'll click on this. Yeah, that one's running a lot smaller. So let's go ahead. We'll do 2880 by 1800 to see what that does real quick. And let's see if that... Oh, and that, of course, then rearranges the monitors. So now I've got to throw the monitor. I think it's this one. I don't know for a fact. Go ahead and grab that. There we go. Okay, there we go. That's a lot better. So I believe that to make your mouse move between the screens fairly accurately, they need to be pretty much the same resolution. I've noticed that. So there's one thing I did want to mention here. It's a bug I've noticed. Sometimes when you generate windows, you'll notice that the window doesn't quite go to the edge there, which is nice in some cases because if you're trying to, you know, resize the window here like that, it gives you a little bit bigger of an area. But sometimes I've noticed, and I don't know if I can get it to do it, I think if I spawn a window off of a window, let's go for 5 windows here. There's my 5th window. Okay, see that time it didn't do it. So sometimes if you spawn a window from another window, it will actually put the box like in the center and you'll have this huge gap between it. I would like to see, let me try to do it here. Oh yeah, 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 I know. It wants me to, I can't have that many screens spawned off that. And then there's another thing. So there, if you'll see when I'm doing that and I'm bending the window, it like warps towards the screen. So that's a bug that I hope they definitely fix. It's not overly annoying, but it just, it's something that all of a sudden you've got the screen like jumping at your face. It's a little interesting. And the slider could use a little bit of fine tuning, I would say, just because it seems to, especially once you've moved it like that and it glitches, there's times where it will catch. So let me go ahead, we'll close, uh-oh. And here's something that'll happen. So I hit the control center and it's gonna try to reconnect. It may, nope, there it is. So I have noticed that if you look up and you hit control center or you accidentally go to the home screen or something, when you go back into the app or when it tries to load back in, it crashes. It has a problem reconnecting. So there's another bug that I would say is definitely an issue that they need to work on. But again, this is in beta. It's not, definitely not production ready, but still super cool. And there you go, there it did it. So if you'll notice up here, I've got this arrow. Now this was the screen that was spawned off of this right screen over here. And let me move this out of the way. There we go, it'll grab it finally. I've also noticed that sometimes on the toolbar here, when you look at it, I mean, I'm looking dead at it and I'll go to pinch, like there, I am looking there. Okay, there it got it, finally. It's, I don't know, its interaction is a little behind. But anyway, go back to this. So if you look up here, those corners, look how far that is. So I can grab that, but it never gets close to that. Now this could also be, and now it's done it to all the windows. Okay, so that is something, and that one's really bad. That is something that's interesting. So when I came back in and it reloaded all my windows, now I've got this like spacing issue where I'll try to pull this here to give you kind of an idea. So there's that window and look at how far apart that is. And I'm assuming that's not meant to be that way. It's just something again with the beta, but that is definitely an issue. But I mean, overall, this is so cool. I mean, I can move between all my screens and I move that one again. So I say I can move between all my screens. I'm betting this is this one over here. So I have no, like, yep, there you go. So that one's that over here. But I've got 5 monitors in my office space. This is amazing. And I can resize these. I can make them, you know, multiple. Let's see, grab that one over here. We'll put this here. Just try to get them a little bit more realistically spaced. We'll grab this monitor over here. There we go. Look at that. I mean, that is just super cool. Now, again, the resolution is a little smaller over here. And you can go in and you can tweak those settings inside of the actual Immersed client in here. So let's go. So you notice I've got all 4 monitors enabled. So which one is at the lowest screen resolution? It looks like the bottom two. So let's bring those up to at least 1920 by 1080. And that's going to, of course, mess around with all of my settings here. There's everything glitching back out again. And that's still there. That is not there anymore. That's probably down. Yeah. So that's something that it does do. It tends to put things in weird orders when you move things around. If you resize windows or something, it loses track of, like, this one was over here and I had it all set up to where I could, you know, move between all the windows, and then I resized one and it put this one back down here. Now, that could be a Mac issue, that could be a Vision Pro issue, or the Immersed app. I don't know really which one, but definitely something that might need to be worked on. Let's go ahead. There was one other thing that I'll close out. Let me see. Oh, see. Okay, there we go. App, and I hit that again. Let's see if it'll connect up. Will it crash on me this time? Maybe. Yep. Nope. It crashed. So there you go. I mean, that's a beta app for you. This is definitely a test. This is why they have open betas, so that they can find these bugs and they can get them fixed. And I know that Immersed is working as hard as they can to get this shipped out. So that's kind of why they opened it up. If you want to check out the Immersed beta, go over to their Immersed channel in Discord and you can sign up. It's AVP Beta Testers. And I'm pretty sure there's a website. I'll try to get the link to it and post it down in the video so you can just go right to it. But I gotta say, that's something I would definitely do if you have a Vision Pro and you want to check out 5 monitors in your Vision Pro. And if you're not doing anything crazy, like trying to close stuff, move stuff a lot, if you don't accidentally look up and hit the control panel, or it works pretty well. I used it today a little bit. Now I have, and okay, see, there we go. So I'm closing apps. That was kind of a test. I wanted to see, would it close out the different screens or would it crash? And that is one thing that it definitely does, is if you're closing windows, especially back to back, it will crash the whole system. But again, hopefully this is something that they fix, and I'm sure that they will. That's okay, there we go. Yeah, I got it on the second try there. All right, so let me see, can I close out this window here? Will it close? It's the question. Try to go down to one screen. It's not gonna close, you watch. So let me think it locked up. It may be crashing. Yep, I can't click on the client. Can I click on the client on my Mac? No, I cannot. Oh, wait, there we go. Okay, didn't crash. That's good. Let's go ahead, we'll configure displays. Okay, so display 4 is the last one. I'm gonna go ahead and disable that one. And, well, there we go. So, I mean, I guess that's to be expected. It's gonna, I closed all the displays, but it did crash doing that. So again, some of this is me kind of trial and error. I'm testing this, showing you what it's like in the headset, just, you know, so that we can test it together kind of. And if you would, okay, there we go. Give me the window. All right, so see there, that's why I wanted to close out all the screens, because I've noticed that if it does the spacing issue with the screens, if you close them all out and get down to a single screen, you can then go from there and like add a screen, and it should, let me see, I think I can add one screen from, yep, you can add one screen from each window that you generate, and it doesn't seem to. Now this is really bad resolution there. But again, I generated it off this window. So I've noticed that's one thing that happens. If you generate a window from another window, it reduces the quality. That's probably because this one is at whatever resolution and then it's cutting that in half. I would assume that's just an assumption. Let's look here. So this is 1440 by 900. Let's go ahead and enable one more monitor. I'm not gonna enable 4 of them. I have done it, but it crashes everything. Let's go ahead and close that out. So again, see there, everything's working nice. I don't have any issues with the bars being too far apart in comparison to, you know, what the screen is. I mean, they're not touching the sides and the corners. I don't know if that's something that the developers want it to do. I kind of like that it's a little spaced away from the side. Now, I will say another thing is, on my other windows, if you're used to interacting with Vision Pro, I have it set up to where I can just dual finger pinch and basically pinch to zoom, and I mean, that's just this hand. It locked onto this hand, so it doesn't capture both hands. You can't grab, look at the window and pull it and actually zoom the window and shrink it. I believe that is something you can do on the Quest, if I remember correctly. I believe you can dual pinch and it zooms. Another thing is, in the Quest, if I moved my wrist, it had like an effect on where the window is. This doesn't seem to have an effect on the window. Like, I mean, I can bend my wrist, I can do things. It tracks, I think, more where your headspace, where you're looking, versus, yeah, I think that's more like, where are you looking based on where the monitor sits. So that's something that's cool. But again, we've got 3 screens, up to 5 screens in Vision Pro running all at the same time. If you're just using one, like throw YouTube over here. I've got like After Effects. You could throw After Effects On one, you could throw your, you know, Premiere Pro on this one. I could throw music over here if I'm listening to something while I'm editing. Some people don't do that. I do. I tend to drown out some of the monotony of editing with music. You could throw, so let's go ahead, we'll spawn another monitor here, see where it puts it. Always try to find the monitor and there, see, okay. So there it threw it. That's why I'm always looking, because I never know where it's gonna go. So let's grab this one. Oh, there we go. All right, we'll grab that, throw this down here. There we go. All right, so we can grab, where did my webpage go here? There we go, so we can grab this, throw YouTube up here. So there we go, we've got YouTube above us. We could be editing a video, maybe watching a color grading video or whatever you're doing to, you know, on your main screen. There I've got my four screens. Okay, well, what happens? I need to add another screen and up. So there's something. I'm gonna close that out and it's not gonna go back in. But that's just, again, hopefully that will be something that is fixed in the future, because it's definitely something that if I'm looking up at a screen, the arrow that shows up there for control center, it pops up. You accidentally click it because you're trying to click on the window to resize it or to move it or, you know, to add another window, and you end up clicking and then closing and it crashes everything. Another issue with the beta right now is that if I'm looking at a window, I've clicked here. Well, there, okay, there it got it, but I can't click the window behind it. So I'm looking at that window, but this window is active. Now I believe that if that goes away, nope, I still can't grab it. So the only option you have is to shrink the window down to where you can see it, and even that's not working. So you slide it down and you've got to get to where you can see that little bar at the bottom. Otherwise you cannot move the window. So if you're trying to get these like lined up here and see, okay, now that's back there, so I've got to move this down, and that one's jumping all over the place. Let's see, so I want this one down here, and I want, so I want this one like right about there. And now I can't interact with this monitor because of this monitor. So that's something that I hope gets fixed later on, is that what you actually click on, maybe that bar comes forward instead of being hidden behind the other monitor. One more thing I wanted to show you before we go is you can go over here to displays and you can set these to portrait. Now I did try this one time and it did crash everything, so we're gonna see what happens. But look at that, there you go. It did not set it, it did not crash everything. So that is really nice. But there you go, you can have a portrait monitor. I don't know again if this is how it's supposed to be, but if you will notice the how far apart the arrows are, that's something that needs to be fixed. The warping of the screen coming at your face, I'll do it again here, like it jumps out at you. It's definitely, and there we go. That's gonna crash the app. That's gonna be it. So yeah, that is Immersed in the Vision Pro with five monitors. It's really cool. I highly recommend checking it out. I will continue to test, and if I find any more bugs, I may make another video. I know they ask us to make any videos we could to show them the bugs. The developers are really working hard to get this ready for launch, so it's not in beta anymore. So if you want to check it out, head over to Discord, hop in their channel, and we will see you in the next video.